I'm gonna get the artifact of the Skylord. Oh yeah.
No! I fucking died.
After we defeated the Broodmother, at least on medium difficulty for now, we decided to tackle the Megapithecus next. We came up with a fairly straightforward plan to defeat it, but we still had to prepare first, and preparing in ARK means farming stuff. We needed a ton of bullets for our fabricated pistols, as well as artifacts to open the boss portals. Tedious, but hey, can't have one without the other.
This is Quetzor. Do I need to left or something in there?
I took on the task to farm the artifact of the Skylord, something I hadn't done very often, but was absolutely sure wouldn't be a problem. Shortly before entering the cave, I pondered whether I should pack away all my good gear, because I remembered Teddo getting lost in there and losing all his stuff. However, I quickly dismissed the notion as unfounded agitation. After all, I did bring my good flamethrower, and mobs should not be a problem.
Which quets are you using? Quetzal. It had some thatch foundations on it, so I just placed some storage boxes on it. But it has 53 level on it. Do we want the levels a specific thing? Do we want to make this in the bar quest? Does this have an high health stat from base or?
As you can see, enemy spawns in this cave are really buggy, because a lot of them spawn behind the pathways. Some of them just randomly fall out when they aggro you, some just stay stuck forever.
Oh yeah,
it's not the highest one.
Oh yeah, I don't know. Could it be?
I forgot I would say, they are like own 5%, you should wait a bit. Until you build on them.
Okay.
Or heal your pets. I would suggest that, I'm not sure.
I mean, we don't want to build one warcraft, right?
Dungeon Master was already on his way to me with the transport quits, so we could move large quantities of artifacts to the base. Artifacts can only be carried by humans, and only one of each type, so we needed to store them in boxes on a quits. I couldn't figure out where the artifact was, so I decided to get my bearings by walking back to the entrance of the cave.
Oh, they're stuck.
Yeah. But some of them seem to fall out.
I'll just wait outside the cave then.
By now, I was already completely lost. But I wasn't quite ready to admit that to myself.
Yes, I think I got lost.
No shit.
Let me try and find my way back.
At this point, I was no longer paying attention to my surroundings. I just wanted to get out of this godforsaken piece of shit cave to meet up with Dungeon Master.
No! I fucking died.
To say I was pissed would be an understatement. You have exactly 15 minutes to retrieve your gear after you died.
Oh, shut up.
But I fell into a hole with a kill trigger, so retrieving the gear would probably be impossible.
Where is it?
In the hole.
I'm gonna fucking quit now.
To top it off, I spawned at what I assumed to be a bed next to the cave, but turned out to be...
Oh, did I respawn now? What the fuck, on a raft?
I had so much stuff on me, oh my fucking god. The thing is, there's a kill trigger in that hole. You don't die from the fall, you die because there's a trigger there. While I was losing my shit over some virtual items, it was Dungeon Master and Demortis that kept a cool head. Demortis then came up with the idea to grapple onto the corpse to get it out of the hole. We just had to be fast because the despawn timer was running.
Yeah, I know. So, let's see.
Do not fucking fall in there. I don't have another,
Look what I got!
Holy shit! Oh, do it again.
I have everything.
Oh, really?
So much, boy, you can't double that.
Yeah, I apologize. I thought it would only work with unconscious, not dead.
No, it worked with that. It even showed a small message, grabbing, dragging body or something.
Yeah, oh my fucking god!
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I did.
Everything is in the... your bird.
So if I could hug you right now, I would, but there's no animation for that, so I'm just gonna do this.
Hoppa.
You all might be pretty confused as to why I was losing my shit over this. This was my personal gear, with my personal skins, dyes, and everything. I don't even PvP with this gear, so it beats me why I was even risking it like that in the first place.
I see. Yeah, you didn't know that either.
Of course not.
After this, we moved on to other caves to farm the artifacts in there. One of the south caves has a weird glitch everybody knows about, but nevertheless never anticipates. If you walk through a specific corridor in that cave, you just get teleported out again. Pretty annoying, but hey, ARK is still an early access title after all.
In case you want to know where I am.
I saw. Just met up with a good old friend. Teleported.
Yeah, you're gone. What the fuck?
I took the snake with me. What the fuck? I took the snake with me.
Yeah, well, it's the snake moves and doesn't
take it. I got teleported as well.
Hello.
I didn't even move. I was just standing there. Okay, that's it. We're gonna go back now.
Then I was gonna go farm escape.
Yeah.
And that's it for today's episode. If you liked what you saw, consider subscribing to this channel, because the next episode will reveal if we were able to defeat the Megapithecus, the giant ape boss.